السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. On behalf of Markaz Sahaba, the voice of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we present to you lesson number 1978 of our daily Nasiha and advice. Today, with the grace and mercy of Almighty Allah Jalla Wala, we focus on the 23rd of Ramadan. It was on the 23rd of Ramadan, the 9th year after the Hijrah, corresponding to the 5th of January 631, the Gregorian calendar. The idol Lat was demolished. Almighty Allah Jalla Wala speaks about certain idols in the Noble Quran, how the Mushrikeen, polytheist idol worshippers would worship them. Afara'aytumul Lata wal Uzza. وَمَنَاتَ الثَّالِثَةَ الْأُخْرَى. So Lat was one, and then Uzza was another one. Manat was one. The biggest idol there, just by the Kaaba, next to it, not far from there, was Hubal. When Mustafa Habibuna sallallahu alayhi wa sallam entered Makkah Mukarrama in the 8th year of the Hijrah, there we find 10,000 Sahabas came. By the Baytullah, inside, outside, there were 360 idols. Habibuna sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with his Mubarak asa, stick and staff, then who'd push them and blast them to smotherings to show them how can you ever worship this, that they cannot assist themselves. How are they going to help and assist you? Islam's essence foundation is based on Tawheed, believing in the oneness, uniqueness, the majesty, the exaltedness of Almighty Allah Jalla Wala. La ilaha illallah. La ma'buda bihaqtin illallah. Truly there is none worthy of worship except Him, Almighty Allah Jalla Wala. So therefore each one of us must realize that there is no place for worship for any creation. We cannot bow down, we cannot make sajda to any creation that is alive or whether passed away and dead. Whether it's a Nabi, whether it's a Prophet, whether it's a Messenger, whether it's Sahabi, Awliyaullah, all that absolutely haram. Therefore, in Salatul Janaza, we don't have ruku, sajda. The mayyit, the deceased, is in front of the Imam, to show that in Islam, bowing down, sajda, prostrating, all this is solely, only, exclusively for Almighty Allah Jalla Wala. And remember, it's an indictment upon the Arabs and the Muslims of this day and this age. Mustafa Rahmatulil Alameen Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, right in his fatal illness, أَخْرِجُ الْيَهُودِ وَالنَّصَارَى مِنْ جَزِيرَةِ الْأَرَبِ. Expel the Jews and the Christians from the Arab Peninsula. What do we see today? We see they're bringing in more Jews and more Christians, and then they want the help of Almighty Allah. Simple example to illustrate the point. Our father, our mother, all are ordinary mortals. In their last moments and last week or so, they tell us something. How much importance will attach to it? We'll say my father's, you know, dying wish, my beloved mother's dying wish and desire. Ya Habibuna Rahmatulil Alameen Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is instructing the Ummah, expel these Jews and Christians from the Arab Peninsula, because this must become a place of Tawheed. It is our foundation, it's our markaz, it's our headquarters, and we must not get influenced by them. Our markaz has to be strong and solid. But alas, what do we see? Instead of we influencing them, they are influencing us. And then we find the Arab countries standing in a line to normalize ties with the rogue apartheid regime of Israel. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Similarly, on the 23rd of Ramadan, the year 584, corresponding to 15 November 1188, the great poet of the Ayyubi dynasty, Usama bin Munqidh, rahimahullah, he passed away. Besides being an outstanding poet, he was also a courageous soldier and mujahid, as he played an outstanding role in the victory of against the crusaders with Salahuddin Ayyubi, Saladin the Just. We should remember that few people only are famous. We have Salahuddin Ayyubi, we have Imaduddin Zanki, we have Nuruddin Zanki, and yea, we hear of others. So there's a whole group of people, and Almighty Allah utilize them for the liberation of Sham, and that is the Levant, whether it be Palestine, Syria, Jordan, Lebanon, parts of Turkey also, some ulama say is part of Sham. So anyway, may Almighty Allah Jalla Wala give our Mujahideen victory. And remember, we are now in the last 10 nights, and we should be turning more and more to Almighty Allah in our leisure time for the pleasure of Allah. Read, Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa fa'afu anna. Oh beloved Allah, you are afu. We know what's the meaning of afu. Afu means to forgive us and to expunge and remove that vices and sin totally from our book of deeds. Tuhibbul afwa, you love forgiving. Fa'afu anna. Ameen, ameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.